London? Yes, London. You know, fish, chips, cup of tea, bad food, worse weather, Mary f***ing Poppins, London.
I don't know if this is something that might interest you, but to have footage, you know what I mean? Anybody that gets props, do you know what I mean? As they get their props, we also have some evidence. This is them then, do you know what I mean? Because quite often, a lot of us, and I say us, because even though I was there then, I wasn't all up in it, do you know what I mean? And I'd be watching from afar like this. Damn, only I could have had the skills.
Yeah, it's a T-Bex from the UK saying peace to Mighty4, peace to Polski.
This is Rob Life from the UK. Just giving a shout out to Mighty4TV.
I'm involved in a lot of work in the communities right across the country with people from all over the world, just like hip hop. My mum was the first person to support me in my hip hop culture. I first learned how to break in my mum's house. The only good lesson that I ever had that taught me to break and pop was paid for by my mum in probably 1984, and it cost her £5 in 1984 for half an hour's workshop. Now that's a lot of money to invest in a 9-year-old, yeah? When you've got 6 kids to feed, yeah? So I'm saying to you parents out there, give your kids the encouragement that they need to go on to be good people, yeah? If they want to do something, please support them. Yeah?
You know, somebody, don't ever let anybody come in your life, be a teacher, be anybody, and tell you that you're a nobody, because we are all somebody.
I don't have an account on B-Boy World. I don't got an account on Freestyle Sessions. That's not my steeds. I don't get down on the internet. When I first started, there was no internet. You know what I'm saying? I find out about jams through my crewmates and shit. You know what I'm saying? They're like, yo, this jam's coming up. I'm like, oh, word? I've been practicing, you know what I'm saying, every week just because I love it, not because of some jams coming up. I practice for me, you know what I'm saying? And I just feel like dudes be on the internet talking shit, hiding behind a computer, you know what I'm saying? And instead of going to the lab and coming through and seeing you in the cypher, they rather see you in the competition when they saving all their moves, when they hitting no cyphers, they're all energized. And dudes is coming out trying to rash on you, trying to do shit that other dudes is doing way before them, you know what I'm saying? And claiming that shit is ill, when niggas been doing that shit for years, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? There's a lot of fake cats in the game nowadays. And I feel like it's just time for the real cats to speak up, you know what I'm saying? And just really get these guys that are coming up, really educate them and teach them, because we're the last of a dying breed, so we really gotta get in there and educate cats before the shit's too late, you know what I'm saying? And it's already getting to that point, so mics. Like, I mean, a lot of cats know what I'm talking about, you know, it's no secret. I don't gotta explain it or nothing. But like I said, that's why I don't deal with the internet, because when I first started breaking, there was no internet, there was no YouTube, there was none of that. There was no cash prize if you was the winner. It was just, if you're with your crew and y'all practice and y'all did y'all thing, y'all go to the gym, represent and win, and y'all just did that just to rep. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, the money's good and all that, you know, but you can't let that overshadow the love that you got for the game, you know what I'm saying? Like, I just feel like that's what dudes are doing nowadays. They're like, not really educating themselves and getting back to the essence, you know what I'm saying? Like, I come from that era, so it's like, it's depressing to me, you know what I'm saying? To see all these cats coming up the wrong way, and it's like, and I'm a young dude, you know what I'm saying? I'm only 20, but money intervenes with cats, you know what I'm saying, wanna hop on the bandwagon, you know what I'm saying? Oh, this crew's doing good this year, so let me get down with them, you know what I'm saying? And then if the crew I'm with falls off now, I'm gonna get with the crew that's winning jams next year. You know what I'm saying? Just hopping from crew to crew, and like, dudes don't understand that shit is like mad whack. Like, back in the day, you could beat up for some shit like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, there was no crew hopping, is what we used to call it, crew hopping. You can't hop from crew to crew. You can't do that. Either you with this crew or you're by yourself. You know what I'm saying? Or if your crew is disloyal towards you, then that's a difference. You know what I'm saying? Then you could be like, yo, I'ma do my own thing, or I'ma head out with these cats because they show me love. Then that's different. But just going out, just hopping on the bandwagon, that's mad whack. You know what I'm saying? Mad whack. That shows how disloyal you are, and that shows how much you don't understand the game and how it grew up, you know what I'm saying, how we grew up. And if you want to like do b-boying, you might as well do it right, you know what I'm saying, because a lot of cats, they end up doing it wrong, and then they educate themselves, and then they start doing it right. You know what I'm saying? It's like, why do that? Just do it right from the beginning. You know what I'm saying? That's, a lot of cats got it twisted, but I grew up around OG dudes in the game, so they taught me about all that, what I was gonna run into, and what type of trials and tribulations were gonna happen in this b-boy game and whatnot, you know what I'm saying? But I never thought that shit would end up like this. I mean, only like, the way I look at it is like, there's only a few real cats out there, and they know who they are, because real recognize real. So